Well, that's good to know. New game. What's up, fondue? I probably would have made that if I didn't fuck up the movement. I can't imagine you would have to go into the 50s or 60s to win. No way that's necessary. That's better. Oh, made the right decision there. Turn order isn't completely random, but it's very, very, very random. Like, you can control whether you go first outside of an unbreak turn or them doing the same by defending. But other than that, all other turns, it's just like, do whatever. Like, speed does have impact, but it's just like the variance is just huge. Like, it's not just whoever has higher speed will go whenever. It's like, consider, like, if your speed stat determined what order you went, that your speed would get rolled between like 1% and 500% before it actually chose the number every turn. Ah! He's a double lizard man! I wasn't paying attention! I'm a goose. There's not been great execution so far. I'm happy with the decision I made against the golem, at least. It's not very often that it's the right decision to... Yeah, I can't kill that. I'm just gonna run. Well, it's also, even if I did kill, it wouldn't have been useful. Because, what the fuck? What the fuck? Osiris wasn't in my party yet, so it would not have helped at all. But, I mean, getting to flee turn one does save a little bit of time, so... time.
無理そうだ。
頑張り。
よっ。よっ。
行きましょう。させません。
That was dumb. Okay, worked out. The reason I did that was I wanted Ophilia to go before the ice things so she could kill them and not have them attack. But if Ophilia had gone before Cyrus the turn after, then the Soulstone would not have hit after breaking Russell, and that would have just been awful. But it worked out, so. Okay, and I got a soul stone there for Tressa encounters. Ophilia first. Perfect. No. Okay, that was a great encounter. Yeah, I didn't bother submitting my 102 to the leaderboards because I'm just going to beat that today, hopefully. These are quick, but they do not give a lot of job points. First encounter was good for job points though, so 31. Yeah, look, it depends. He might get there, he might not. Hello? I did it again with the fucking save point. More birds. Oh, I'm such an idiot. I was not even thinking about SP at all, just was not on my mind. Okay. so I'm at 37 on the Cyrus. So, as long as I get one encounter that isn't birds, I'll probably get there. Fish, that's good. Why is Cyrus last? Yeah, 53, so he'll probably get there from, even if I only get one more here. And then the one in the cave. That's bad. I've gotten enough birds though that I skipped analyze before that fight. So he'd need 18, so probably not actually. I think there's something that gives 18, maybe the bats? I didn't make it anyway, so I'll get there for sure. 3 birds, I'll skip analyze again. Okay, that was a better turn order. So okay, pretty good Tressa. Oh wow, really good Tressa actually. I didn't think my time would be that good here, but that's really nice. I suppose I did get really good turn orders like all the way through. Ugh. That might kill me. Oh dear. I've just gotta try and run away. Awesome. Well, that's so unlucky. At least I made the double risk that time. Oh, that sucks, dying to that encounter there. Because the only way it fucking happens is if it gets caught by surprise as well. God, I got a 21 in-game time this time. If only I didn't die, would have been great. Okay, I'm gonna take a risk here. Try and save a bit more time. Okay, I made it. So it just saves a little bit of movement getting that soul stone a bit later. But it's a risk because if you get an encounter before getting into this area, then you don't have a soul stone to kill it with. Thank you. Thanks, JP. I've seen a bunch of artwork making fun of, like, Therion stealing, like, you know, little kids, like, candy or whatever. But the funniest one to me when I was playing casually was, when you're in Saintsbridge post-game, there's a kid that you've got to get, like, the flowers off. But if you take them with Tressa, it's like it doesn't change what his dialogue is. It almost assumes that you're taking it with Therion. Because his line is, "Hey, that's mine!" But then Tressa just says, "Always looking for a bargain." I love that. Well, that's an experience, I guess. Doesn't help job point-wise, but it might give me a little bit of health boost to, potentially survive a consuming darkness attack from old mate Matthias. I did forget about one soul stone. There's one on the way to... Everhold Tunnels. You get 9. You should have 3 spares. Oh, this is nice. 2 attacks before Heathcote, so he's not going to get a turn. Good Therion. Hello? No, Alright, pray for tunnels. It's a run. Good. You are fucking kidding me. Even, like, I had a higher chance than I usually do because of the extra levels. Still didn't fucking get it. Bullshit. So I'm down on money now, I'll have to get the 8k chest in the Seaside Grotto. Hello. A lot higher than I thought I would be there. 71. Oh, because I killed the Kate. Of course. That's why I had more money than I thought I would. So I can probably get away with getting the 3k instead of the 8k. Damn it! Shouldn't have done it. Ugh, and I was caught by surprise. Fuck me. No, no, no. Well, I'm definitely fine on money now. Fuck, I'm gonna lose time on this slot though, for sure. Yeah, Ophilia can definitely go sub one, obviously. Hello? Fuck. Okay, that's a good encounter though. No, 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 item. That's why I like keeping the light soul stone. Where's a fucking soul stone, dude? Okay. I got a really good turn pattern there, but it took me a while to figure out exactly what to do with it. Okay, but I used my light that time, so I have to get the one in Perg. Yeah, no, the fight went perfectly, it's just that my menuing was a bit slow because I was trying to figure out exactly what to do. So I could still get sub 1 on this run if I get no encounters, and then first try. Matthias and co. But like, I would have to get no encounters, both in Perg and in Whisper. Western Whispermill Flats. Here we go. Ah! No. Fuck. None of them hit me, did they? So I don't have to heal. This is an awesome setup. I've got a merchant going after only one of them attacking. So even if it firestones. Alright, Matthias, come on, mate. Good.
おめでとう
Perfect fight. One, he's done it. And two. Sub one. Hooray. So I'm happy with that. I got a sub one. That could obviously be improved because I still had a death to the fucking... unbelievably, to the Stone Guard encounter. I died. It's an unbelievable place to die. But I got sub one. Like, yeah, I could beat that, but it'd take a lot of good luck at this stage, so... I think I'm going to move on to a different character for now. Like, I can always come back to Ophilia later on if I really like this run and really want to improve it later. I'm really happy I got sub one. Happy with my improvement every day that I've done runs. Day 3. Get that sub 1. Now we'll move on to someone else. I still don't know which character I'm going to do next, but it'll probably be one of the other 3 that I use in this run. So either Cyrus, Tressa, or Therion. I'll just see what I feel like routing later on today. So let me just think about that run. So my start was good, my Cyrus split was good, my Tressa split was amazing. I had the stupid death to Stone Guard. Then I took the risk, and my Therion split was... Yeah, no, I took a ton of risk on Warp 2 after the death to try and minimize the time loss there, and it all worked. My Therion split was really good. Because I still had the Ice Soulstone, only got one encounter, and it was a fucking a Caitlyn. Warp 4 split was perfect. Ugh, Saintsbridge. I went for the extra cash. The 5k. The 3k wouldn't have been enough though. Oh no, I didn't sell. It would have been enough, but I would have had to sell probably my jam, which would have been fine given how the Matthias fight went. So my Saintsbridge was not good. I got an extra encounter there. Going for the chest to make up for the... And I got the scrutinize. Terrible luck. Then Goldshore. I got the one encounter, but it was super quick. And then ending. My chapter 4 boss was awesome. My chapter 3 boss was awesome as well. Put like perfect turn order. I didn't play that well, but it was the perfect turn order. Like, I chose all the right things, it just took me a while to actually choose them. Matthias was perfect, like, turn order, and he didn't kill anyone. Like, there wasn't even, like, the extra turn as well. Like, it was Cyrus at the end, and he just didn't attack. It was perfect. So, realistically, if you got a really good run, I probably lost... about a minute to the death. And then a minute 30 in Saintsbridge. Maybe not a minute 30, maybe like... Yeah, so we'll say 2:30. With those two things going well. And then everything else goes really well as well. So like an amazing run would be a 56. It'd just get sub 57 if you take 2:30 off this. That would be like amazing for Ophilia. With this route anyway. But like I said, I'm happy with sub 1 for now. This is a good, interesting experience for me. I've never really run a game, like, this new. Like, I mean, I had to buy a bloody... an HD capture card just for running this game. Because... I've never used one before. But like, my... because, you know, I'm quite goal-oriented with what I want to do with games or whatever. But so it's just... the setting of goals is quite a bit different with a game that released, you know, like a month ago versus a game that released over 20 years ago. Yeah, I guess that too, because I'll probably stream those when they come out day one. I probably won't run the, at least the 2018 one, but I'll probably still stream the first playthrough of that. I'm actually not a huge fan of the Fire Emblem games, honestly. Like, I preferred, like, Advance Wars 2 and Advance Wars Dual Strike a lot more for that type of genre. I don't know, like, I'm also, like, I actually don't play that many games, and, like, I definitely don't buy that many games. The fact that Octopath actually got me to even buy it is just a huge compliment to how good it is. Like, I just played the demo of this game when I got a Switch, having heard absolutely nothing about it, and I just fell in love instantly. Fuck, I have to buy this game. And then I bought it twice, because I bought a I have a physical and a digital copy of the game. Because I originally got a physical one, because it was cheaper. But then I thought the digital loads were like way faster, it turns out they're only a little bit faster, but whatever. I was like, I'll do runs on digital then. I mean, I could always sell my physical copy, so it's no big deal. And I got my physical copy for way under value as well, even though I pre-ordered it. I've bought three Switch games. It's just been an absolute steal on all of them. Because, like, this is Australian dollars. I got Octopath for 61, I got Tropical Freeze for 33, and I got Odyssey for, I think, 51. I've already sold Odyssey back, and I sold it for over 70. I could easily sell Tropical Freeze back for probably about 60, and I could sell Octopath for probably about 85. At the moment, so. Well, there it is. Finn. Alright, well, thanks for watching that, guys.